Essential NLP. Practical skills for a great life. Hi, and a very warm welcome from me, your host, Phil Parker, to Essential Skills of NLP, podcast number 25. Thanks again for everyone who's tuned in to this podcast across the world. Thank you so much. If you love this podcast, and I'm getting lots of feedback that people are really enjoying it, then please leave a review on iTunes, and of course, tell your friends on social media. The more people that get to hear this, the better. So today we're going to look at something called modeling, which is absolutely core to NLP. If we go all the way back to the presuppositions of NLP that we started with, where we talked about what are the foundations of NLP, there are a number of things that lead us towards modeling. One of them is, if somebody can do something, then other people could potentially achieve that. Modeling is really the distilling of this idea. It's saying, okay, if people can achieve excellence and a level of brilliance at something, then if we could only understand how they do it, and sometimes why they do it, then we could break it down into simple enough steps to teach to somebody else. One of the things that NLP excels at is this idea of modeling, and implicit with that is the idea that things are modelable. Very often people will say, well, you know, he was born with that talent. He's lucky to be able to do that. NLP begins with a question, which basically says, well, okay, he is good at that. But does that mean it's inherent in him? He was just born with it and only people born with that talent can have it? Or is it something that we could learn to become good at in the same way as he is? We talked about this before, that we're probably not saying everybody has equal talents and ability to achieve exactly the same degree of brilliance in every field. So some people may have more of a tendency to be a more extraordinary artist or a more extraordinary musician or to run faster than others. But could we just put that to one side for a minute and think, how could I emulate them as best I could? How could I become really good? A good example of this is language. Very often you'll have people say, you know, I'm no good at learning languages. But even within that statement, they've already shown that they are pretty good at learning languages because they've just spoken in English or whatever their native tongue is. So to me, it would make much more sense to say, well, I've already mastered one language. I'm quite good at these things. It must be pretty easy to master another language. And yet, in school, language is one of those things that seems to be quite hit and miss. Some people will spend 3 years learning French or Spanish and come out with virtually no understanding of it, and other people will seem to take like a duck to water to it. And this, I think, could be interpreted in two ways. One is, some people are good at languages or not, and I think that's not the case, because as I say, everyone has already learnt their native tongue. Or the methodology that we're using to teach people how to speak isn't quite up to the task. And this is one of the core problems with brilliance. People who are really good at something tend to be really poor at teaching it to other people. Naturally, people who tend to end up being language teachers are likely to be somebody who finds it easy to learn language. But unfortunately, this makes them the least likely to be good at teaching somebody else how to do it. Because for them, it was such an easy process, they probably can't understand how anybody would find it difficult. And they're probably so good at it that they've forgotten the steps that everybody who wants to learn a language, and particularly those who are struggling, need to know. And this is where NLP leaps in. It says, okay, if you have achieved the skill of, say, learning a language, then it is achievable. How did you do that? What steps did you go through? And the steps are not just I went to a learning course, training course, or I read a lot of newspapers, or I listened to Spanish radio a lot. Those are useful pointers, but we really need to know what's going on inside. How are we approaching this? How are we seeing this? I was talking to somebody the other day who was able to speak 7 languages. And one of the questions I was intrigued by was, how did he know that, for instance, the word donkey or pain was in this language different from another one? And how did he remember which one to use when he's speaking one particular language? Which is kind of an interesting question and a very NLP question. So how did you distinguish that, the how question? What's going on there? Asking questions that don't normally get asked. And what we found out was when he thought about a word, and we looked at similar languages like French, Spanish and Italian, and Spanish and Italian are particularly similar. And we asked him about the word pain, and he was very clear. He said, Spanish word for pain is here, pointing to his left, and the Italian word for pain is here, pointing to his right, and it's a different colour. And we start to pick up submodalities, and we can distinguish that he has a way of filing this information, so he's not confused at all about which word fits in which language. In this particular example, he said that he felt the Italian language is more alive and vibrant and passionate, and so it was coloured red and bright, and was kind of italicized, whereas for him Spanish wasn't quite as passionate, and so it was a cooler colour, kind of blue, and off to the left. So we're going to pause there for a minute in our exploration and modelling. We're going to follow this up in the next podcast, where we talk about, well, how do we model, what do we need to do, and when would we use it? But this is just a brief introduction to get you started on the idea of modelling. I do hope you've enjoyed this podcast. If you'd like to get hold of the next in the series, then please go to the store at philparker.org. There you can also find out how to sign up for the transcripts of many of these podcasts, extra bonus content and information about latest NLP webinars and seminars run by me. Essential NLP.